Simon & Schuster Audio presents The Leader in Me, How Schools Around the World Are Inspiring Greatness, One Child at a Time, by Stephen R. Covey. Read by Fred Sanders.
Every now and then, life invites us to pause and seek a higher vantage point, a place where we can scan the horizon and reevaluate our courses and destinations. May this audiobook provide such a moment for you. In tribute. It was during final preparations for this second edition of The Leader in Me that Dr. Stephen R. Covey passed away. He was in his 80th year. It is hard to imagine how Stephen could have lived a more vibrant, meaning-filled life. He literally spanned the globe teaching timeless principles of personal and organizational effectiveness. Millions of people credit his influence for having bettered their lives. When Stephen graduated from Harvard University's MBA program, it was assumed he would take a lead in his family's prospering business. Instead, he told his father he wanted to become a teacher. And he did. He spent the first 25 years of his career teaching university students. He loved seeing students' eyes light up when catching a new glimpse of their potential. His classes became so popular, they had to be moved to an arena. With time came numerous requests from corporate and government entities for Stephen to teach employees the same principles he was teaching students. Regardless of where he went, he captured people's minds and hearts and inspired them to greater heights. Those opportunities eventually led Stephen to leave the university to help build the Franklin Covey Company, which grew into one of the most influential leadership companies in the world, one that still thrives today. All the while, Stephen always considered himself first and foremost a teacher. As the sun began to set on Stephen's professional career, many assumed he would slow down and spend more time with his family, which he did. Nevertheless, he never stopped pursuing his motto, "Live life in crescendo." He always believed and worked as if his greatest contribution was yet ahead. But what could such a greater contribution possibly be, considering the professional legacy he had already accumulated? In his final years, Stephen's passion returned to the classroom. In the time since his landmark classic, The Seven Habits of Highly Effective People, had been published in 1989, more than 500,000 educators and over 3 million students had been taught The Seven Habits, mostly teens and university students. That thrilled Stephen. But what captured his energy even more was the excitement that was starting to bud at elementary schools. It began in 1999 at A.B. Combs Elementary in Raleigh, North Carolina, where some very creative teachers started teaching The Seven Habits to elementary school children, even to four-year-olds. What made their approach unique was that they were not just teaching The Seven Habits as a curriculum. Rather, they were using The Seven Habits as a framework for transforming their school's culture. In very little time, A.B. Combs went from being a school in dire need of improvement to being the number one magnet school in America. Discipline referrals dropped dramatically. Student self-confidence rose. Staff and parent satisfaction soared, and test scores went up. Soon other schools were implementing the same process with similar eye-catching results. As word spread, people literally started approaching Stephen to insist he had a moral obligation to write about what was happening. In response, Stephen released the first edition of The Leader in Me at the end of 2008. It hit a nerve that started a wave of its own. Today, 200,000 copies of that edition have been sold, and more than 2,000 schools have begun implementing the Leader in Me process. In getting these schools underway, much has been learned. Many best practices and tips for how to launch and sustain the process have emerged. So the decision was made to pursue this second edition of The Leader in Me to capture at least a slice of the new stories, the new clarity, and the new vision. Sadly, Stephen passed away before the project could come to full fruition. Therefore, it has been with much humility that three of us have united to finish this manuscript. As an introduction, Sean Covey, Stephen's son, is Executive Vice President of Franklin Covey and leads Franklin Covey's education team. Much of his career has been devoted to bringing the Seven Habits to students via his best-selling books, The Seven Habits of Highly Effective Teens, more than 4 million copies sold, The Six Most Important Decisions You Will Ever Make, and The Seven Habits of Happy Kids, which is tailored for younger audiences. All were New York Times bestsellers. Muriel Summers you will come to know throughout this audiobook. She helped pioneer The Leader in Me as principal of A.B. Combs Elementary. In addition to her daily responsibilities at the school, she is an outstanding keynote speaker and a proud mother. Dr. David K. Hatch brings a depth of experience in leading transformational change in corporate, government, and education settings. He was the lead researcher for the first edition and has since consulted with hundreds of schools across the globe in implementing the Leader in Me process, while also filling the lead research role for this second edition. Stephen would be the first to insist that credit for what is happening at the schools go not to him or to us, but to an expanding community of committed, creative, and caring educators who have synergistically joined forces with parents, business leaders, and civic administrators to bring a measure of new hope to the field of education. Literally hundreds of teachers, superintendents, principals, parents, professors, and school board members have contributed wise input and rigorous review of this work. We honor them. Additionally, Stephen would extend heartfelt gratitude to his long-standing partner, Boyd Craig, who from the beginning provided visionary direction to the overall scope of this work. He, along with Franklin Covey Education's team of consultants, client partners, client service coordinators, and headquarters team, has offered significant insights. Their talents are exceeded only by their passion to help students and their professional service to educators. In presenting this work, we are keenly aware that today's educators have been the targets of much negative press in recent years. Such is not the aim of this audiobook. Rather than being critics, we prefer to promote the good that is happening in education. Indeed, it is rare to visit any school these days without leaving in absolute reverence of some incredible teachers who sacrifice much to make daily differences in young lives. We honor the greatness in them. So welcome to the second edition of The Leader in Me. We hope you find what you are about to hear inspiring. If in your listening, you become impressed by what these educators are doing, we invite you to deeply consider how you might use your strengths to bring such an opportunity to a school or child near you. We hope you will join us in helping today's students to live more effective, fulfilling lives, both today and in the years ahead. Sean Covey, Muriel Summers, David K. Hatch, Ph.D. www.theleaderinmebook.com. Chapter 1. Too Good to Be True? When I first started telling people about this leadership model, there were several naysayers who thought it all a bunch of fluff, but now they are believers. Leslie Riley, Seminole County Public Schools, Florida. When the first edition of The Leader in Me was published toward the end of 2008, it began with the story of Drs. Rigg.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.